Hi, I'm Mrs. Walkowitz, your new chief of academics, and I'm proud of you, even though I'm just meeting some of you now. This is a really special moment that recognizes all of your hard work and dedication throughout your high school career. And it's even more of a feat that you are being recognized during this year of virtual slash hybrid learning. I'm proud that you were able to overcome and rise above the challenges of this year. We can use the pandemic as an excuse for why we can't move on, or we can use it as a motivator and find our purpose. And I think that's what you've done. And think about that as you get your award. I'll leave you with a quote from Eli Manning. He says, "Challenge yourself. What is your barometer of success? Don't downgrade your dreams to fit today's halting reality. Don't let the new normal be an excuse for standing in place. It's up to you not to become the class that never was."
Hi, I'm Neil Moakley, and I'm the high school department head for mathematics here at PPAX. I teach pre-calculus, calculus, AP statistics, and in those classes, I get to work with so many really incredibly talented seniors. It's a privilege, but unfortunately, it makes award ceremonies like this a little bit tough. Every day, the math department and I interact with enough award-worthy students to fill our classrooms multiple times over. Tonight, I'd like to recognize three of them in particular. So this first student has gone out of her way to take some of our most challenging math courses. Both in our classroom and before class and after class, she asks thoughtful, reflective questions, and she never, ever lets me off the hook until she feels that she has this thorough understanding of our most complicated ideas. She owns her own learning. She never settles for good enough. The award for perseverance in mathematics goes to Kathy Lee. I sometimes think this next student might be able to read my mind. I've lost count of the number of times that his observations or his predicted solutions have just anticipated where our lesson was going to go next. His intuition for the material that we've covered and just his clever reasoning overall made him one of our stars in AP statistics. The award for creative thinking in mathematics goes to Will Cermelli. As a math team, we always hope to cultivate a mathematical mindset in our students. Now, this means encouraging them to think deeply through a mathematical lens about the world that surrounds them, recognizing patterns, developing their quantitative reasoning skills to make sense of everything. This next student has never needed encouragement from me to do that. From the moment I met him, he's balanced excellent work in honors and AP classes, sometimes two AP classes at once, alongside a relentless curiosity about math, about science, and about the world. He just wants to know how it works. The award for mathematical mindset goes to Michelangelo Borghese.
Hi, my name is Ted Stevenson, chair of the English department. I will be presenting the senior awards. The first award goes to a student who demonstrates creativity through his sense of humor and ability to conjure amusing combinations of words on the fly. Through his ability to ask questions, question his questions, and then debate those questions with himself and others, and through his interesting and original projects and papers. The award for creativity in English goes to Damon Sees. The next award goes to three students who challenged themselves to take advanced language and composition, demonstrated excellent work all year, and also received a 5 out of 5 on the AP exam. The AP Language and Composition Student of the Year awards go to Sophia Gronchevsky, Olivia Phillips, and Jasmine Duong. And the final award goes to a student who showed a level of foresight and long-term goal-oriented thinking that has impressed every English teacher she has had in the last 4 years. She has committed 100% to every assignment, drafted every draft, and gone every extra inch to make sure that she sets her life up for success. The award for perseverance in English goes to Tatum Calabrese.
Hi, good afternoon. This is Mr. Ben. I teach French. I've been teaching here for last 7 years, and I'm here to present the awards for my French students. So this award, the first award for overall excellence, recognizes students who have demonstrated all around excellence in academic work as well as contribution to the class community. Le Grand Prix de la Langue Française, Overall Excellence, goes to Amaya Adams. So the next award is going to be for, this award says it all, Attitude Extraordinaire, Extraordinary Attitude for Jenny Chen. And the next award is for, this award is given to a student with consistent high-level performance in French class, excellence, outstanding performance. This award goes to Nazaya Daniels.
Hi, I'm Mr. Orlando, head of the science department. The Earth Space Award goes to Maria Hadim. The Excellence in Chemistry Award goes to Jasmine Duong and Kathy Lee. The Excellence in Physics Award goes to Michelangelo Borghese and Sofia Gonceschi.
My name is Joseph Tatro. I teach high school social studies and am the department chair for the department. We have 3 awards in social studies that we like to give out at brunch each year. The first one is our Underdog Award in social studies, the second is our Passion Award, and the third is our Presidential Award. So the first award that we have is the Underdog Award in social studies. As described by Mr. Jones, this student is someone who has shown over the years growth in not only themselves personally, but in their academic and personal pursuits. Whether in the weight room or in the classroom, this student has shown dedication, drive, and a real grit for doing their best, for treating others with respect, both teachers and classmates, and has shown that growth really can come powerfully in the 4 years of high school. And so this year, we proudly award the Underdog Award in Social Studies to Mr. Aaron Gary. Our second award is the Passion Award in Social Studies. As described by Mr. O'Neill, this student has shown passion in social studies throughout their career in high school. Even when an assignment is given to the class, research is given, this student goes above and beyond to find more information, deeper information, and then doesn't just use that for themselves, but brings that information to the class to enrich class discussion and create something truly unique and truly powerful, in a way that really honors the passion of this award and the spirit behind it. So the award for passion in social studies goes to Mr. Amir Whitaker. The Presidential Award in Social Studies is awarded each year to someone who shows passion, drive, and leadership in their social studies classes throughout their career. The student who has received this award this year has shown all 3 in their time here at Philadelphia Performing Arts. They've shown passion and drive in discussions, pushing other students in the class to be interested and motivated by the content in ways that they may not have otherwise. They've showed passion and drive outside of the classroom by advocating for the student body, even starting and leading a town hall meeting each month in just their sophomore year to advocate for positive change in the school. And so for all of these reasons, and all of the admirable skills and powerful impact that this student has had in social studies and outside of the social studies classroom in their high school career, the award for the Presidential Award in Social Studies goes to Emma Ferry.
My name's Eric Finaro. I'm the health and phys ed teacher in the high school. I'm also the athletic director for the high school sports. My first award goes to a student who showed excellence in my health and phys ed course. Not only was she a hardworking student, but she was dedicated to her attendance as well, Kamara Morgan. My My next award goes to a student who showed sportsmanship in athletics. She was a four-year soccer player and team captain. She always put in hard work and dedication. This female sportsmanship award goes to Angie Abaruki. My next award goes to a student who not only put in hard work throughout his 4 years as a basketball player, was able to develop his not only his game, but also his personality and his leadership. He also tried to put in a day of baseball with me. He is one of the hardest working kids I know and was one of the easiest that I was able to coach over the last 4 years. The Male Sportsmanship Award goes to Jovace Nelson. My next award goes to someone who was a four-year athlete in multiple sports here in our high school. Not only was she an all-star athlete, but she was an all-star student, one of the top in her class, and she was dedicated to everything she put her mind to. The Female Scholar Athlete Award goes to Lorena Dinage. Final award goes to a four-year baseball athlete that was not only able to become a captain by his senior year, but also was an all-public contender and finished in the top of his class academically. One of the easiest guys I was able to coach and one of my true leaders of the team. The Male Scholar Athlete Award goes to Blaze Rago.
The Edward Leffler Leadership Award is presented to the student who overcomes obstacles and reaches his or her fullest potential at all times, perpetuates a consistent good nature attitude and sense of humor, exhibits role model behavior, leads by example through noticeable achievements both inside and outside of the classroom, strives to maintain focus and sticks to the tasks in order to get the job done, and demonstrates an ability to work positively and collaboratively with others while fostering exemplary contributions to the string theory school community. I proudly present this award to Jin Jun Zhang.
Hi everyone. I'm very excited for the start of our new journey after high school. But let's take a moment and acknowledge all the time and work we have put into these 4 years. I remember when I joined NHS, I really wanted to be a part of everything, working with others to help big ideas seem more achievable. With a group like NHS, we have the ability to work together for the school's climate, the community, and the city. The only limitations are the ones we place on ourselves. So now, speaking as president, I hope you will continue to work hard and work together. Never stop collaborating and being a part of the group, especially one comprised of people like you. Congratulations, senior class of 2021.
Hi, I am Mr. Tamaro, the band teacher at String Theory Schools, and I will be presenting two awards today. This one award will be to a student who has shown constant dedication and hard work here in the band program at String Theory Schools. I wouldn't be able to have done my job here without her. This award, the John Philip Sousa Award, will be presented to Kathy Lee. The second award I will be giving today is to two brothers, and they are extremely talented musicians and have really shined this entire year in the virtual setting. They have worked super hard on all of the music they've been given and really have shown their dedication to the band program. The Music Excellence Award will be given to Isaiah and Nisaiah Daniels.
The National Orchestra Award is the highest honor given to a high school orchestra member. This year's recipient is Justin Williams. The Music Achievement Award goes to William Cermelli. The Music Excellence Award this year has three recipients. It will go to Jenny Chen, Zhaodan Chen, and Jasmine Duong.
Hi, my name is Rosemary Schneider, and I am the School of Performing Arts Department Chair. I will be presenting the Vocal Music Awards this evening. The Music Excellence Award is presented to a student who has taken and excelled at the AP Music Theory exam and displays exceptional musicality through their ensemble performance. This year's recipient has been a PPAC student since kindergarten, has sang as both a soloist and ensemble member in every PPAC's choir, including concert choir, of which she was a member for all 4 years of high school. In addition, as a junior, she scored a 5 on the AP Music Theory exam. I am honored to present the Music Excellence Award to Alyssa Mishuli. The Outstanding Vocalist Award is presented to a student who displays excellence in artistry and vocal performance. This year's recipient has an infectious love and passion for singing and brings joy and encouragement to everyone she encounters. She has been a strong leader in our choirs and will be greatly missed. I would like to present the Outstanding Vocalist Award to Juliana Gallagher Santiago. The National School Choral Award is the highest honor for high school choral performers. It recognizes the dedication and musical achievement of the choral student. This year's recipient has been both a soloist and ensemble member throughout her time in the vocal department, acting as a leader for her peers. As a junior, she earned a 5 on the AP Music Theory exam, and in the fall plans to continue her music studies as a music education major. I am proud to present this year's National School Choral Award to Kayla Elliott.
My name is Natalia Sharova, and I'm presenting Classical Ballet Department. This award would be given to the student who spent the most time with me in my major, the long enough that we had to learn, both. I learned how many obstacles and difficulties this student had to overcome being my major, and hopefully she learned discipline and most of all, passion for that beautiful art. The award for resilience and personal progress is given to Jamila Allen. I would like to give the award for artistic and creative achievement to the student who unfortunately only spent a few years with me, but it's been absolute pleasure, a sunshine in my studio. This award is given to Kiana Carpenter. And with all of my pleasure, I would like to give award for the overall achievement in classical ballet to Sofia Granjevsky.
Hello, my name is Ali Willingham, and I am the Contemporary Dance Major teacher. The Overall Achievement Award goes to Vanessa Williams. The Artistic Excellence Award for Contemporary Dance goes to Amira Brockington.
Hi, I'm Jody Letizia. I teach high school theater. Compassion, consistency, and dedication embodies the characteristics and spirit of this award. This award is for theater dedication, and it goes to Olivia Phillips, Amani Smalls, and Isaiah Glover.
I'm Matt Grimaldi. I teach TV broadcasting here at String Theory. Very proud of all of my senior TV broadcasting students. The award for best editing goes to Shaitasia Shirley. The award for outstanding leadership goes to Steven Solon. And the award for outstanding scholar goes to Kira Fernandez.
My name is Andrew Maniski, and I teach high school 3D design and animation. The first award I'm going to be giving out is awarded to the student with the highest consistency of excellence throughout all 4 quarters of 3D animation. The award for highest overall GPA in digital design is Gino Russo. The second award is given to the student that has shown the most perseverance in their creativity and has strived to never stop learning. The Most Growth and Development in Digital Design Award is given to Aiden Fair. The last award is given to the student that has challenged the definition of normal art, developed work that is uniquely personal, and presented themselves as a forward thinker. The Digital Design Thinking Outside the Box Award goes to Damon Sees.
Hi, my name is Ms. Wimberly, and I teach high school experience design. So, this first award, the Ian Spalter Design Innovation Award, is awarded to a student who shows passion and innovation while creating meaningful and well-designed projects. This award goes to Suad Dorsey. The Excellence in Design Thinking is awarded to a student who uses design thinking, which is inspiration, ideation, and implementation, in order to think outside of the box and to go the extra mile to solve problems creatively. This is awarded to Ruby Lee. The Dedication to Design Award is awarded to a student who exemplifies perseverance, dedication, and drive throughout their time in experience design. This is awarded to Francesca Haas.
Hi, I'm Laurie Doran, Studio Arts Instructor, and I'm here to give three awards to my students. So the first one will go to the student with the vision to generate meaningful ideas, making connection to society, and demonstrating the capacity of art to advocate for change. The Creative Thinker Award will go to Clady Kaja. So this award is going to go to a student who embraces every challenge as an opportunity to learn. They are evidence to the thought that positive attitude leads to positive outcome. The Enthusiastic Learner Award goes to Akela Wood. And this award will go to a student who doesn't allow the fear of failure to impede their desire to explore. This student embodies the creative spirit of innovation and creativity. The Fearless Creator Award goes to Marie Barron.
Hello, my name is Miss Walker, and I teach the High School Engineering and Computer Science STEM track. I will announce the awards for Engineering Computer Science. The Engineering Mindset Award recognizes the student whose thought process most closely mirrors that of a professional engineer. This student shows great curiosity and problem-solving skills. Like all successful engineers, they're an effective communicator, a great collaborator, and have a drive to figure things out. The award for Engineering Mindset goes to Bobby Del Campo. The Excellence in Engineering Award recognizes a student who demonstrates technical excellence and embodies all aspects of an engineer. Engineers must combine mathematical and mechanical skills with creativity. And this student further expands on those competencies with persistence, teamwork, and leadership skills. The award for excellence in engineering goes to Jewel Moreland. The Great Collaborator Award recognizes a student who stands out among the rest when it comes to working on a team. This student not only shines on any task that requires teamwork, they also help their fellow students. The award for the Great Collaborator goes to Sydney Henderson.
Good evening. My name is Dr. Hannah, and I teach life sciences and biotechnology and am the department chair in STEM majors. Fulfilling a passion and achieving success in a discipline requires consistent work and dedication. You don't just become. This student had a long-term vision from day one and has shown the perseverance, work ethic, and curiosity to make it a reality. And he's a good person. The Dedication in Science Award is given to William Hirschman. This student has really come into his own over the past 3 years, adding unique perspectives, a commitment to ideals and opinions, and that humor. He doesn't often use it, but his voice is mighty. The Rising Star in STEM Award goes to Marino Chitalo. No team, work group, or class can hold together without those members who provide the glue. That is this student. She works well in any group, holds herself to a high academic standard, takes on both personal and lab responsibilities, makes sure things get done, and is just present, even while virtual, where I can rely on her to unmute and say, "I'm here." The Citizenship in Science Award is given to Maria Hadin.